taking place. This may affect your journey over the festive period.
Oh, you're far away each night.
Do you want any spray? No? No worries. Cheers. Hey there, bangers and mash, or should I say, boppers and goblins. It's your boy, Rick Glassman, taking you overseas to the home of U2, Haggis, and Lord of the Rings. London. Welcome, Watson.
Or should I say, Holmes?
Sherman Holmes.
We're having a bit of connection issues on the audio.
Fuck. Are we going?
Yeah, I'm rolling.
So this here he is, the great detective, Sherlock Holmes. Statue was commissioned by Neil Paul Harrison in 1884. You can see he's wearing a deerstalker hat and a pipe. A lot of people don't know this, but Sherlock Holmes was inspired by a teacher named Bethany Belosky. That's B-E-T-H-N-A-Y-B-E-L-O-S-K-Y. The term elementary, my dear Watson, was because she was an elementary teacher. And because of the times, they made Sherlock a man, obviously, instead of a woman. But technically, Sherlock Holmes, along with, you guessed it, Doctor who was also created by Stephen Markett and Mark Goddess. Yeah. Thank goodness we finally got Doctor Who to be a woman.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's only due time until Sherlock is has a pair of tits.
There's different people have played him over the years, obviously.
Benedict Cumberbatch and the guy that does Iron Man.
Maybe. Are you on a TV program or something?
Yeah, I'm filming, because I'm from the States, and I'm filming, showing people around.
Oh, yeah.
It's my first time in London.
Where are you? What state are you from?
I'm from Cleveland, Ohio, originally.
Cleveland, Ohio.
But now I'm in Los Angeles, and boy, are my arms tired. Or I just flew into...
See, I've got relations in...
Do you have that joke here?
No.
Where people say, I just flew in from somewhere, and then
That's
they
say... It's a bit feeble, isn't it?
Well, I don't know. I think it's kind of smart.
What time would you go and see a Chinese dentist?
2:30.
Ah, you've heard that.
I've heard them all. What time would you see a Jewish dentist?
No.
1:45.
Well, I'll give you a clean one then. Have you heard of the game of snooker? It's like pool, but an advanced game of pool.
Okay.
Okay, guy goes to the doctor, and he says, doctor, he says, I can't stop eating snooker balls, see? And the doctor says, impossible. He says, how can you possibly digest them? He said, that's why I'm here. Right, the doctor says, five reds and five yellows, because he reminds me of bacon. And he says, what do you have for your dinner? Brown or white? No problem, old son, he says, you're not eating enough greens.
Oh, the green balls?
For health.
For fiber, yeah. That's funny.
That's not bad, is it?
Is that yours?
No, it's Tommy Cooper.
Tommy Cooper.
He was my hero. He used to wear a fez. He's dead now. He died on stage, actually.
He died on stage?
Yeah.
You know, he's so good, instead of killing the audience, he killed himself. Welcome to another episode of Take Your Shoes Off with, what's your name?
That's a good one. Mike.
With Mike? Mike?
Yeah.
Mike. My name's Rick Glassman. Welcome to London. Well, I want to move on. I got to get a coffee.
I've got to get to go and see my boys at Fulham.
Go Fulham, baby.
We don't call it soccer over here, mate. We call it football.
Football.
Go see the boys down the cottage, mate.
Let me try that. Hold on. Oh, you gotta see the boys down at the cottage, eh?
Down the boys down the cottage.
And the boys down the cottage. Put it in the fucking ass and fuck him in the asshole.
Stick
their fucking tea up their fucking asshole with their big cocks and their pussies.
No, you Americans have this thing about posteriors, I noticed
that. We love to take it in the ass. We like to take it in the ass.
I like a nice cup of tea in the morning.
I'm going to grab a coffee. Do you want something?
Strong espresso, please, that's what they call it.
What makes it strong? A double?
Yeah, it's a double espresso, basically, but they call it strong in French.
Be right back.
Good man.
So that's Mike we just met. Lovely man. To be honest with you, I'm a little bit afraid about being close to him.
The man yourself, as the Irishman said.
I don't know. I don't really have any more to say about it than that, so.
My child, you said, had a bit of an accident on the old bouncing castle.
A strong espresso straight up in one of them. Could you just put a splash of oat milk in there?
Yeah.
Thanks.
If I were the authorities, he said, I would come along, take your child away, and put you into prison. That's hilarious.
Are there two of these or just one?
Sorry?
Two or one?
Yeah.
Cool.
And actually, so he was telling a pack of lies, and the kid was over there in the first place. It was very funny, that.
Hello. Thank you. Is it Mike or Mark? Fuck.
He's a hard-bitten old curmudgeon, isn't he? I'm kind of like that.
Mark?
I don't like
Mike?
Nothing.
Watch this. They wanted to know what name I should put on this.
Well, I'll put this nickname Eric.
I'm going to start calling you Eric then.
Yeah, I like Eric actually.
Yeah. You want to see who could drink it fastest?
No. Okay. I like to take it slow, man.
Well, let's take it slow.
Lord only knows. That's a song actually. I'm coming up with.
Lord only knows what I'd be without you.
It wasn't that particular one, but that's a good song as well.
The only thing I'm worried about is sound. I don't think it's not gonna work. It's like Abbey Road.
Sorry?
Abbey Road, the Beatles thing.
As long as we live, it's you and me, baby. There ain't nothing wrong with
better
that.
Better for everyone's coming on up to the east side. Abbey Road. Should we go? So in London, they call these the rubbish bins. You have recycling goes in here, and then you put your...
Up the city.
Up the cities in here, and just trash in there. Is this the way we're going? They have ITZU, the T-Mobile version, and they have ITZU, the Sprint version. The Sprint version is obviously a little bit faster, but the T-Mobile one has the flip phones, the kickers from Entourage. You remember when they were in Aspen, what's it called? The festival? Sundance. It's beautiful. They have this little alleyways, they're called Marylebones, and it's where you can, your apartments are down at what seems like an alleyway. A mosaic, oh, pardon me, or excuse me. Be cool. That was the Royal Guard. I hear that you could actually, can you actually go up to them and you could say like stuff and they don't move? Oh yeah, but don't ruin the scene, Betty. We're doing British comedy over here. She doesn't get it.
They say it's not nutritious, but still it is delicious.
You know, this was actually a coffee shop run by Henry Swartzen or Swartz. You could grab it, Joe and the Juice. During 1942, they changed it to the Juice when Adolf Hitler took over England. And yeah, they got rid of all the Jews and turned them into the Juice. This is a play on how all British people have bad teeth. And they used to say, could you please fix my teeth? Do you remember, do you know what time it is when a British person has to go to the dentist? We'll cut to a clip. 1:45. Tooth hurty? I don't know. Oh, right on. Hey, man.
This is Liam as well as my friend.
Hey, it's a pleasure to meet you. Could we hear them okay? Would you mind telling us a little something about yourselves?
Yes, so I'm Joe, I'm 26. I live in Birmingham. We've just got off the train. I'm going to a festival today, so that's why we're here.
Yeah, I'm Liam. I live in Liverpool.
Beatles.
Yeah, Beatles. Yeah, Lark Lane. Oh, no, Penny Lane. Yeah.
Oh, does she live there?
No, it's the Beatles Street.
Penny Lane.
I think it's a song. But yeah, anyway, and I do IT for work. And, yeah.
How come you told us your age, but you didn't tell us your age?
Oh, I'm 26.
Small world.
Yeah, okay.
Give us a little fact about something about London that we could put in this.
Oh, we don't know anything about London. We've just got
it. Here,
is this where Sherlock Holmes used to live?
I think
this is where Sherlock Holmes used to live?
Yeah, I think so.
That's a fact.
For real?
Yeah.
This is 106 Baker Street. This is actually where Sherlock Holmes... This is Sherlock's Holmes. Hey, guys, would you mind, just in case, if we use this sign in a release?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's no more because we'd plug it.
No, I'll plug mine.
Yeah.
All right, well then here's what we're gonna do. Try it once and then I might give you a direction.
Okay,
you ready? Nice. You want me to start at 3 or 5?
5.
It gives you more time.
Yeah.
Start at 10.
10.
10. 9. 8. 7. Fuck yeah. 6. Tighten up your abs. 5. 4. 3. 2.
What's up, everyone? Subscribe to Joe Vlogs. That's VLOGGS on YouTube. I've got 119 subscribers. After this, I reckon I should have about 500. So do your thing. Big up everyone in London. Shout out to Sherlock Holmes.
Say big ups.
Big ups. Big ups. Oh.
Blup, blup. Yeah. All right, peace.
Peace.
Peace. Say peace, motherfucker.
Peace, motherfucker.
That's a cut.
Oh, that's nice.
Brilliant. Keep it rolling, though.
Tough boss.
What the fuck did you just say?
It turns your meat to leather, but let's all die together.
Welcome to Harrods, one of my favorite places to dine. Some fantastic chocolates. I don't know if they're gonna let us film in here. Let's see. Hi, pardon me. Thank you again.
Sorry, sir, you can't film in. We've got to leave now.
Nope, let's check out some sights. Taxi!
I like a nice cup of tea in the morning for to start the day, you see.
Are you waiting for a cab? No? All right, I just don't want to cut you. If you get one of the license plates, you'll see it's like in the Bourne Identity movies. They're like thinner with the little numbers on them, or like an Italian job. Did you get one of the license plates so they could see? In London, the black cabs, are you allowed to say that, black cabs? Is that what you call them here? The black cabs, they have to take this thing called a knowledge test, which they know every nook and cranny. Could you say nook? Oh, they have blue cabs here too. I don't know if there's, do blue cabs take the knowledge test? Do you know? I just hear they're the same, but they're a little sadder. Come with me. Are you open? Are you available? He's a little sad. You available? Ooh. Are you available? Don't tell Betty, but the women in London are so choice. It's filming for my podcast. Take your shoes off. It's hard to hail a cab in London. It's probably where the saying comes. Are you a cab? Not a cab. Oh, there's one across the street. In London, you can do whatever you want. You can just run across the street. What do you say to get a cab here? Cabby, cheerio, pit, pit. Yes, yes. Hey there, we're going over to Big Ben.
Yeah.
You know where Big Ben is?
Yeah, I think so.
The knowledge test. Great, thank you. Come on, follow me. Thank you so much. So you know where Big Ben is. I understand that the cabs here, they know everything.
Yeah.
Is there any street that you don't know of?
Sure.
Where is Big Ben? That's in central London, right?
Yeah, Harlem Square, yeah.
Like the American Harlem Square, where the Globetrotters are from.
Parliament.
Parliament. Now, the House of Parliament was created in 1774 from Queen Elizabeth, who actually derived from the great Northern Yorkshire, the Pillament. Which derives, of course, from Pillet Pharmis, which is the pharmaceuticals of all things that are, it's an older time, but the white part of it for. Now you can see there's telephone booths here. There's two types of telephone booths. There is the royal telephone booth, and then there is the, I believe they used to be called the peasants telephone booth, which is for the common folk to use. Is there a difference between the royal and the regular telephone booths? Isn't there something?
No.
There is nothing different. Ooh, Selfridges. This is a very famous department store. You could get things like your pipes, your Sherlock Holmes pipes, you get sweaters. Or you call them knickers here, I believe. Look at how beautiful, they just eat outside. You know, they all speak English. A lot of people think that English is an American language, but English actually derives from England, which is where the Queen is from. In 1743, the Yorkshire Parliament derived into two separate but equal parcels of government, and Daniel Boone, Marshall Bodie went over to the States. They started a new country, something about getting tea to be cheaper. Benjamin Franklin, Teddy Roosevelt, George Washington, John Adams, played by the great, what's his name? Whatever. Here is, you can see the red brick. You'll notice a lot in London, there's red bricks and there's white bricks. The reason they do that is it's just kind of like the color scheme that they like to do. I don't know, should we bleep when I said, bleep when I say knickers? A lot of people don't know this, but Big Ben actually isn't called Big Ben. It's called something else, and people just call it Big Ben because the guy who did the bell inside, he liked the name Ben, so they call it Big Ben.
I'm gonna actually look up some Big Ben info.
Some folks put much reliance on politics and science.
Clicked over. See, a lot of people don't know this, but Big Ben isn't formally known as Big Ben. It was referred to as the Clock Tower up until 1985 when Back to the Future came out and they renamed it the Queen's Parliament. The reason they did that was because there was a lot of tourists coming there and trying to, like, do Back to the Future stuff. So Big Ben is, it may not be a formally Ben, but it is formally big. It weighs almost 14 tons, which is like the size of two Tyrannosaurus Rexes. So yeah, it could keep time and it could crush it, my friend. The hour hand is like 19, 20 feet long, but the minute hand is 23 feet, which is the first clock where the hour was shorter. The reason they did that was because the Queen wanted it that way. She thought, oh, what if we made the hour hand, okay, small? And, you know, at first people were, you know, people were freaking out about it, but it turned out all right. You know, in England, they have a metric system. So instead of feet, they use meters. 1 meter equals 3 feet. 3 feet equals, you know, a good time. Look at that, 116 Parliament Way. This is where the House of Representatives meets. Queen Henry, Charles Montgomery, and the fifth sister of the Elizabeths used to live here until they separated, and they have that in the Green Park, is it called? Ah, yes, the ice cream cone, the English ice cream cone. Queen Elizabeth III's ice cream cone. In 1847, the ice cream cone was made because Queen Elizabeth loved ice cream. But what did she love more than ice cream? That's right, keeping what they call in England fit. So instead of having a taste, they would offer her this big show, this grand gesture, which is where we get grand gesture from. It is located at the National Galleries of Trafalgar Square, which is just a very famous square. In England, there's squares and courts. In America, as we know them as malls.
Do you want to talk about the big lions that they have at Trafalgar Square, the famous lions?
Mm-mm. You see here, there's the Canadian Embassy, which is also kind of like we were talking about before with the Bourne Identity movies. Look at that, beautiful. That's where the mayor of London lives. Mayor General Sir Henry Havlick, who was born in 1846, who died tragically in 1946 on his 100th birthday, no doubt. The cherry on the ice cream cone fell off and crushed him, which is where you get the saying, the cherry on top, because he lived to be 100 years old and the cherry on top is what killed him. There's Big Ben, there it is. Look at, it doesn't look that big in person, does it? That's the thing about Big Ben, it never looks huge. What is this, Betty? Yeah.
It's been like that for about 3 years, yeah?
Yeah. I was here a couple years ago and there was having construction. It's like, what are we, in England or on the 101? An English cab. Aren't they beautiful? Cabs in England are a little different than in the States. Cabs in England are the highest form of transportation. Oh, pardon me.
Sorry, man.
Oh, cheers. You say cheers when instead of thank you here. Pardon us. Oh, you can go ahead. It's cheers. There it is. The clock tower from Back to the Future. Oh, I'm sorry. You know what? You guys go ahead. Pardon me. Cheers. We're standing outside the House of Parliament where all the big decisions are made. Like the West Wing if you're an Aaron Sorkin fan. Think of a British politician. You've probably seen him in there drinking a cup of tea, perhaps. Except if it's Boris Johnson. He's so foolish, he probably spills his tea on his lap and burns his dick. Could you say dick here? But it's better than Keir Starmer, who's such a bubbling fool that even Queen Elizabeth III thought he had a little cock. Cock? Cock. Anyway, it also happens to be right outside Big Ben, as we talked to you about earlier in the cab, or as we call it the, I hate to say it, I won't say it. Anyway, yeah, this is it. Think about like all the times, all the things that have happened here in England have all been kept on time with Big Ben. Come with me. Now right across the Thames, we have the London Eye, or as it's often referred to as God's Ferris Wheel. It was established in 1984, just after the Starburns manufacture hiccup pop of Queen III. Come with me. Now, if you notice, the London Bridge happens to be down at the moment.
This bridge doesn't lift up. Like, yeah, that's one.
Come back to me. One camera's fine.
Apparently, this is not the London Bridge. This is just a bridge in London. It doesn't go up, but it's beautiful nonetheless.
And a nice cup of tea with me tea. And when it's time for bed, as I think I may have said, I'd like a nice cup of tea.
Westminster Abbey, formerly known as the Collegiate Church of St. Peter Westminster, was made in 1066. Oh, pardon me, we're gonna hold for bus. No, I'm just a little bus British comedy. They're fucking weird over here. Hey, I wanna show you something, come with me. This is the home of all the coronations of the royal family since 1066. 39 coronations happened here, with the most recent being, of course, June 2nd, 1953, with Queen Elizabeth II. Cheers. And how fitting, spoiler alert, that when Harry Potter and Voldemort, oh, I mean, he who should not be named, meet, here it is with us, our goblins and boppers meeting at one of the most beautiful, not just cathedrals, but pieces of architecture that man or woman has ever built. I offer you Westminster. Pardon me. That kind of shit, do me a favor, you always follow me with that, would you?
Oh, yes, sir.
Not a big deal, but that's strike two.
Well, my idea of heaven is a...
Bourne Identity. Bourne Identity. Bus tours, hip-hop bus tours. Hip-hop bus tours, $39.95 gets you on, nothing gets you off. Better than all the sights you can see, from DMX to Run DMC. Hip-hop bus tours. You can stay as long as you'd like or just see the sights as you might. That's hiphopbustours.com/TYSO for 20% off your first tour.
Sounds great.
There you go.
Thank you.
They sell themselves. Hip-hop bus tours. Hop on, hop off. As long as you don't mind hip-hop, you know, you get it.
It's just 39.
I made a mistake earlier. It is not $39.95. It is $39. Hop on for $39. Oh, pounds. Fuck, that's like $60. It's a hard gig. Yeah, absolutely. Please, thank you. Yeah, enjoy. It's amazing. Bus tours. It should be illegal to pass up a deal like this. The Queen's Guard. Hop on, bus tour. Big bus tour. We got one left. Who's gonna be the lucky lady or the lucky gentleman? And it doesn't matter because it's a new day. Whatever you identify as, you can identify as having a great time. Yes! We sold out! The umbrellas are heavy and boy are my arms tired. That's bigbustours.com. Thank you all so much. I wanna get this and I'm gonna fly away, so get. All right. And boy, my arms are tired. Well, that's London. Make sure to come along with me next week when we visit Toronto.
Again, oh dear, where do you belong?
Get the people behind you. Get the people when I'm zooming, there's people behind you. Look behind you across the street. Back to me. You can clear out and we'll get Chris's. Peter, Benny, you gotta back out all the way. Peter, your job is to get reactions from everybody wherever. All right, that's a cut.